Now, ONGC management would have been hoping for a better start to 2018, especially since there is growing clamor around the upstream giant bearing a part of the burden of rising crude prices. It's also in the middle of merging its biggest buy till date, HPCL, with another subsidiary, MRPL. Joining us now to talk about the fourth quarter numbers and the implications of the rising crude prices is the Chairman and Managing Director, Shashi Shankar. Welcome to the show, Mr. Shankar. Also joining me from our research desk is Sumit Sarkar to take the conversation forward. Sumit, over to you.
Thank you, Neeraj. So, Mr. Shankar, in the fourth quarter, if you see exploration costs and other expenses were higher compared to the last quarter. Any specific reason for the same?
Exploration cost, if you talk about what happens whenever you do an exploration activity, so your success rate is not more than 50%. So 50% of the cost which you incurred towards exploration, be it survey or the exploratory well, that is required to be written off. So it is just, there is no definite pattern like, I mean, if you have done some wells and some quarter, you had some better success or less success, depending on that, the write off quantity, that also varies. So there is not something very significant.
Also, oil and gas production numbers were down sequentially. What was the reason for the same?
It was mainly because in the offshore, we had some planned shutdowns we had taken. We have a project called LEWP, I mean Life Extension of Well Platforms. We had some of the platforms which had gone, were pretty old, in excess of 40 years, and those platforms need were required to be either repaired or were required to be replaced. So for that process, what we had done, we had taken some plant shutdowns in Mumbai High and also in Neelam Hira redevelopment project. Certain hookup work was required to be done. So on that account, we had taken some shutdown. So that's the reason the production you see on the in the fourth quarter was low. But if you see year-on-year basis, there has been an increase in crude oil production, and that's very marginal. Or you can say it is almost same. There was an increase of about 0.3%.
And what is your total production target for financial year 2019, both for oil and gas?
It's about 22.75 on a standalone basis and another 3 million ton from the joint venture.
Given for a longer period of time, say for the next 3 years, what is the gas production target that the company has planned for, given the fact that government is planning to increase its focus on gas and energy mix of India?
As for the gas production is concerned, the projects we have in hand and the kind of discoveries we have made and the plans we have, from the present level of 23.5 billion cubic meter per annum, it's likely to exceed 40 billion cubic meter per annum. That's almost 75% increase in gas production by the year 21-22.
Former CMD of ONGC had said in an interview that gas prices at $2.48 per MMBTU was not a profitable business for ONGC. Now that the gas prices have been revised to around $3.06 per MMBTU, do you think that these prices are sustainable and good enough for the gas business? If not, what could be the appropriate price for the gas business?
See, what we had been saying, if you just see the average cost of production today also, for our, we have got major production is taking from offshore. So our average cost of production is in excess of $3.5 per MMBTU. So at present level also, we are not been able to recover the total cost of our production. The best way, in my opinion, to go forward is, I mean, the government, what is they're thinking about the exchange hub. Once that comes into existence, and if the marketing freedom is there, probably we'll be able to realize the better price or whatever the price the market decides, and that whatever price, maybe $4, $5, $6, whatever price we get, that should be good enough to monetize the discoveries which we have made.
Brent crude is now around $76-$77 per barrel. Do you expect these levels to sustain for financial year 2019?
Going forward, you might have seen in the last 3-4 days, it has come down from $80 to $76. So basically, if the whatever the production cut which was there from the OPEC and the Russia, if they increase their supply or they pump more oil, then what is the forecast is by different analysts and the agencies, it's going to be range bound about $60 to $70 in the long term.
If you expect the crude or Brent crude to be around $70 per barrel for financial year 2019, but if you see the petroleum subsidy allocated by the government for FY19, now that is largely unchanged compared to the last financial year. So do you expect that to be revised, or do you think there could be subsidy sharing by the upstream companies in FY19?
See, so far we have not received any communication from any quarters with regard to subsidy sharing. But what I have come to know from the media, even that happens, and what you are talking about is some windfall tax when the crude oil price is above $70 a barrel. If you see in this FY18, the average realization for us was $57. So $70, I think that is really, not a concern as far ONGC is concerned. Even if there is some kind of windfall tax above 70, we are really not too much concerned about it.
So you don't expect any subsidy sharing till $70 per barrel rate?
No, this is what I have learned from the media. A windfall tax when the oil prices goes up above 70, yeah.
Lastly, nearly 4 months have been done with the HPCL acquisition. Are you seeing any early synergies from it?
See, as far after the acquisition of HPCL, I had just shared with my other media friends that at a group level, our crude oil production is 35 million tons. If you see the refining capacity, that is also very close to that, 35, 36 million tons. And the marketing also is 36 million tons. So with acquisition of HPCL, we can claim to be a truly vertically integrated energy company. Going forward, what we have done, we have constituted a committee. They are looking at different committees, looking at short-term and long, mid-term and a long-term basis, the benefits which can accrue because of the synergy between all these companies. So the work is in progress.